everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to share a topic: do humans really use only 10% of their brains? Absolutely not. Humans use only 10% of their brain. It is not true, but it is a myth that just won't die. People have been repeating this myth for decades. Psyche people who say they can tell what others are thinking or predict the future often repeat it. They say that people can learn to use the unused 90% of their brain for psyche activities. But it is not true. All of us use almost all of our brain every single day. Brain is more complicated than any computer. Brain receives messages about everything your body does, like seeing, hearing, tasting, smelling, and touching. Then it sort out this information by doing some heavy work. Brain, it remembers things, compares them, and sort them. It solves problems you did not even know you had. It also figures out what the other part of your body should do in any situation. Brain is capable of generating consciousness and mental processes by which we perceive, like act, learn, and remember. Product of our brains are like thoughts, perception, memories, and emotions. Brain task. Brain controls breathing, heart rates, and body temperature. It instructs muscles to contract and pull on the skeleton to your body and move. It processes information from sense organ and skin receptors so you can feel and experience your surroundings. It stores and retrieves memories. It thinks, reasons, and imagines. It produces and controls emotions. Brain has three main parts: cerebrum, cerebellum, brainstem. Cerebrum is also called as a forebrain, and cerebellum is called as a hindbrain, and third is brainstem. Cerebrum, it is the largest part of the brain and is composed of right and left hemispheres. It has different areas that receives different kind of messages. One area gets all the messages about hearing, another gets all the messages about touch. Cerebrum has some subparts. Frontal lobe, which controls personality, speech, and emotions. Parietal lobe, which processes sensory data. Temporal lobe, which identifies and processes sound. Occipital lobe, which processes visual information. Cerebellum is located under the cerebrum. It sits at the bottom of the brain. It is in charge of coordinating muscles. Cerebellum is also called as a little brain. Brain stem. It acts as a relay center and connecting the cerebrum and cerebellum to the spinal cord. This tube is in charge of keeping automatic body systems working. It keeps your heart beating. Did you know? Brain grows up until you are 20 years old, but it never stops learning. It can make new connections until the age of at least 100 or more. It seems it would be hard to do all these things with only 10% of the brain, doesn't it? PET scan shows that humans use all areas of the brain. PET scan. PET stand for positron emission tomography. It is an imaginary test that allows doctor to check for diseases in the body. The scan uses a special dye containing radioactive trackers. These trackers are either swallowed, inhaled, or injected into the vein in the arm, depending on what part of the body is being examined. Brain consciousness is awareness of your own existence and your own surroundings. Consciousness is not controlled by one particular part of the brain, but depends on the activities throughout the outer layer of the cerebellum, that part of the brain that is responsible for memories, thinking, personality, and so on. Human does not develop a sense of self until they are above 18 months old. Left and right brain. Left brain functions are analytic thoughts, logic, reasoning, science and math, number skills, and it has right hand control. Right brain functions is art awareness, creativity, imaginations, intuitions, holistic thoughts, music awareness, and left hand control. Unlearned behavior of the crying baby. Baby knows that they have to scream and cry to get attention, because stores in their brain are instincts inherited from our ancient ancestors. Butter brain. Butter tissue is so soft that it could be easily sliced through with a butter knife. Luckily, the brain is protected by the tough bones of the skull. Neuroscientist Professor Norman, who has built his career around the 10% claim. It is estimated most human beings use only 10% of the brain capacity. He says, imagine if we could access 100% brain. In the movie, do human use only 10% of their brain? You see staring Scarlett Johansson and Morgan Freeman. His mysterious drug allows Lucky to use 100% of her brain's capacity instead of the typical 10%, giving her access to the range of amazing powers. Even then, neurologist Chris Sathishian debunks the lingering yet popular myth that people use only 10% of their brains. Thank you for watching. See you soon in the next video. Hope you will have enjoyed YouTube series. Bye bye.